And welcome to Significant TV, significant stories, significant entrepreneurs. I'm your host, Fran McNeil, and joining me in the studio is Michelle Gillet. Michelle is founder of The Business of Doing Good. So let's now find out more about The Business of Doing Good by talking with Michelle. Michelle, welcome to the show.
Thank you, Fran. It's terrific to be here. Thank you so much for inviting me.
Well, it's my pleasure. You know, it's funny how friendship works.
Yes.
We were introduced by Ginny Durham.
Mm-hmm.
We had dinner. You were telling me about this thing that you were so passionate about.
Yeah.
And as you talked about it, I thought, gosh, she's an entrepreneur. She's a social entrepreneur. And she's a woman with this background of ed tech and business and travel.
Mm.
And I just thought you'd be a great guest to have on the show.
Well, thank you. Thank you.
You're welcome. Now, I know a little bit about your background, and
mm-hmm.
but let's start first with The Business of Doing Good.
Okay.
What is it, and why did you start something that is really designed to help primarily children? And
Absolutely.
Yet it's connected to this world of entrepreneurship.
Absolutely. So The Business of Doing Good is a social entrepreneur program for middle school kids, kids that are 10 to 14 years old. And we have boot camps in the summer. We're in Boston and Philadelphia, and there's many other cities that have asked us to come. And then we do advanced workshops throughout the school year where kids get continuing education and entrepreneurship. They get mentoring, they get coaching. So whatever projects, whatever passion they have, the program is designed to put their passion into action.
Passion into action.
Absolutely.
And the Business of Doing Good. And you have this abbreviation, BODOG?
BODOG.
BODOG.
That is our, the kids came up with that as our hashtag BODOG. Absolutely.
I love it. Now, you have a very interesting backstory
mm-hmm.
and a significant story as to why this particular activity. I mean,
mm-hmm.
you were in corporate America.
Absolutely.
And you chose to leave. Tell us about that, because the journey towards social entrepreneurship is really kind of fascinating.
Yeah, so my story is a very personal story, I'm sure, like many entrepreneurs out there. So, as you said, I was an ed tech pioneer, worked, you know, climbed the corporate ladder, was very entrepreneurial, always entrepreneurial in big companies, and was living in San Francisco, and I was doing global business development for National Geographic Learning, which was a partnership between ed tech corporation and, of course, National Geographic. And I was brought on board to sort of start that business from an operational standpoint and then to do global biz dev. And so I was traveling around the world, living in San Francisco. I moved back to the East Coast, and I had an 8-year-old daughter at the time. She's a little, slightly little older now. But when we moved back, I really felt like I wanted her, what as a parent, as a mother, could I do to really ensure her a thriving, successful, joyous life, right? As parents, that's what we want. We want the kids to be joyous and to have their dreams, whatever their dreams are, come true. And at that time, I left National Geographic Learning, and I was going through a career journey myself. And so I really thought about, what does it mean to be successful in today's business world, not only as an adult, as an executive, but as a child. And so to me, all roads led to entrepreneurship. So I looked for programs for my daughter, especially at that young age, on entrepreneurship. And what I really found is, and what I really felt in my heart, was that I wanted her not only to learn to be an entrepreneur, which really means solving a problem, bringing an idea to fruition, but it also meant really making the world a better place. And that really is a direct impact from the incredible adventurers and explorers I met at National Geographic, who were climbing, you know, to the tops of mountains or diving to the bottoms of water caves. And I always asked them this question, Fran, and that question was, what gave you the guts, basically, to do what you do? And the answer to that story was always, or the answer to that question was always, I met someone or I knew someone. And so to me, what I wanted to do was create a program for kids at a very young age where they would be inspired by people, but they would also feel like I can do that too. So that's cool. I can do that too. So that's what I did, is I put together a program that has many entrepreneurs. I'm so fortunate that so many people have helped and have really supported. One thing you'll find about entrepreneurs is they are so giving and so generous. And I've had the pleasure of being around entrepreneurs on a daily basis now. And so every day in our program, the kids meet entrepreneurs who are doing super cool things, but they meet entrepreneurs who are making the world a better place, either for profit or nonprofit. And then what we have done is we've created a curriculum really based on my executive leadership training that I've had through the years, but written at sort of that middle school level. So kids can feel like, oh, I can do something like that too. So they choose a project. We work with them really closely one-on-one in a project-based format to create a project, and we take them to the pitch stage at the end of our boot camp. And it has been just an incredible experience in so many ways.
Well, I see your face light up, and we have talked a number of times about that pitch experience. Many of our viewers are familiar with Shark Tank. A lot of people watch Dancing with the Stars, which is where people perform, and there's a competitive element. People watch The Voice. And in many senses, most of those programs do try in a way to show that you too, based on your talent, could be on this world stage.
Yes.
The pitch is a unique experience because an individual takes their idea and in a very short period of time shares it and has to captivate and involve others.
Right.
For middle school students who have seen another entrepreneur do something and then suddenly have the opportunity to say, this is the project I want, how do they handle that pitch experience?
So funny you asked that question, because I never really thought about that. I just thought about this is a curriculum. In the end, they pitch. That was sort of the natural thing. And our kids practice their pitches very early, almost from day one. They get a lot of practice. And they do an incredible job. I have heard so many people. In fact, I just met one of our hero entrepreneurs who is now a later stage startup. She's probably has one of the most successful startups in Philadelphia. And she made a comment that the ideas and the pitches from the kids when she was with them were better than she's heard throughout her career as an entrepreneur. So kids have something authentic and genuine about them that really is attractive. And frankly, they're kids. We want them to succeed. We see them. We're sharing in the joy and sharing in their ideas. And so that pitch stage is really, and frankly, the ideas and the comments and the competitive analysis and the business planning, some of their ideas are better than I've heard from my colleagues through the years, tenfold. I mean, it's just absolutely amazing. And that was a surprise for me. I thought I would be much more of a teaching, you know, life enrichment, but the exact opposite has happened, is that by working with this program, by building this program, the things that have come back to me have just been tenfold. It's really been, I really say that it's feeding my soul. It's just a life-changing experience.
Right. When we were talking earlier, you shared that there's a process. I mean, you have two sites in Philadelphia and Boston. Other cities have asked you to create the program there. How do people get involved in the 1 week camp, as well as if they're in Philadelphia, how do they get involved in the more year-long program? What's the process?
Well, they just have to come to our website. Our programs are open to anyone. TheBusinessOfDoingGood.com, and they can find out about our programs. We have partnered with a incubator this year that is really going to have representatives at our expos, at our pitch session the last day in both cities, and they will be working with the kids throughout the mentoring process throughout the year. And people just have to sign up. That's been one of the challenges that we've had. This is been a journey for me, entrepreneurial journey. I've done everything myself. As an executive, I had a lot of people to help me, but it was really important for me at this stage to do every single thing myself. And so one of our challenges is getting our word out and spreading the word and including as many people as possible.
Well, I'm happy to be a part of it, and I know that lots of people will be watching, so yep. You shared how they can find out and register. The other thing that some people may be viewing and wondering is, so how much of a difference does this make mm-hmm. to a child? And what's an example of a real life child that participated in the program, and from their perspective, what did they get out of it? So in a minute or so, yeah. how would you share that?
Well, I will share what parents and kids have told me is that the two words that keep coming back is, my child has more confidence than he or she ever had. My child has more courage. We are determined to build courage into kids, to make them feel like they can make a significant impact in making the world a better place.
So courage and confidence. And I know that on our screen, one of the images that you shared were thank you letters. And what's the story behind those?
The thank you letters are to all of the heroes who come to our program. So that array of thank you letters was from 1 week. So the kids have such exposure to top people who are entrepreneurs in the trenches. And you know the funny thing, Fran, is that now the parents are coming in and sitting in on our session. So we're really building a community of support.
I'm excited for you.
Thank you.
I have watched you grow this. Mm. What's next for the business of doing good? If you could wave a magic wand, where will you be 2 or 3 years from now?
Well, I'd like to continue working with these children and with this youth to give them more opportunities. And so I would say it would be including more children who have never, ever thought of an option of having exposure like this. And really bringing the kids to different cities. One of the things that we tried last summer was having the kids Skype to each other. And they loved that. And now we're entering our third year. And the kids who have been with us from the first year are now sort of counselors in training. They're going in, just starting high school, and they're counselors in training. And so it's really creating a continued ecosystem of support for our program and including more families.
So you've mentioned support. Mm-hmm. What can people do if they don't have a middle schooler, mm-hmm. but are really interested in helping the business of doing good continue to do good?
Oh my gosh, that's a great question. Well, we're a 501c3 nonprofit, so they can always donate money or support a child. And if there are entrepreneurs out there, which I'm sure there are many who follow you and all of your work, they can volunteer to work in our program and share their inspirational stories with the kids and come to our programs.
Well, good. I am going to definitely recommend that people do that.
Great.
The business of doing good, Michelle Gillet. You know, it's so exciting to have folks from corporate go through their own personal journey and, like you, enter the entrepreneurial world and then say that they want to share it.
Yes.
How often does your daughter participate in the process?
Well, she's just old enough now, and so we're going to have her go to a program where everyone doesn't know who she is. But she was lucky enough, I was lucky enough, that she joined us at Philly Tech Week. We had a table at Philly Tech Week, and so she came up with a project that she wants to do based on the slime that the kids are making, and she wants to do a seasonal slime business. And so, look out, world.
Okay, we'll find out more about that. Well, Michelle, it's been a pleasure having you on the show. Our time is running out, but in fact, in general, for the business of doing good, the world is your oyster.
Oh, thank you, Fran.
There's plenty of time to continue to support organizations like Michelle's, the business of doing good. Michelle Gillet has created an opportunity for middle school students to explore entrepreneurship and get more courage and more confidence. It's a significant program that deserves your significant support. Significant TV, significant stories, significant entrepreneurs.